All right, now we're ready to add some textures to the floor and the countertops. So Photoshop is really exciting because you can use the exact materials that you want to show your client. So sometimes we find materials online, which is what we're going to do in a minute. Sometimes you might want to scan in an actual sample that you have from a showroom. So for what we're going to do right now is let's find a nice marble countertop that we want to use. So what I'm going to do is go online. And we're going to look for white marble, but there's a specific terminology that I want you to get used to using for Photoshop, and that is texture seamless. And I'm also going to put in the word JPEG. So let's talk a little bit about what that means. Here, I'll go over to images so we can take a look at these and find one we like. So texture is just kind of the terminology we use for anything for the image that we want to use. Seamless means that when the pattern repeats, it's not going to tile and look kind of weird and choppy. If that doesn't make sense to you yet, it will as we continue. And then JPEG, JPEGs are the type of file that Photoshop prefers to use. You'll see that some of these might be, let's find one we like. What is this one? I'm gonna just right click on it. I'm gonna say save image as, it says it's a JPEG. Okay, let's try and save it then. That's what we want. So we'll call it, see, here's my textures. I'm gonna call it white marble one. Okay, let me try and find one that's like the wrong kind of file. So sometimes it'll say that it's saving it as a JPEG, but it doesn't actually. It'll save it as a Jiffy, which is not good. Doesn't like those. Photoshop doesn't like those. And maybe because I put JPEG up here in my search bar, it is being nice and only showing me JPEGs, which would be great. So we saved a couple. I'm gonna do one more. Oh yeah, Pinterest is usually bad. Let's try it. So I have a couple options here so that I hopefully won't work. Another thing I'm going to be doing is flooring. And I want to do, there we go. I'm just going to try and save some time by doing them at the same time here. Let's do wood floor herringbone texture seamless JPEG. Of course, what we're going to use. Oh, look at all these beautiful options. So pick one. Right click, save as. You can see I already saved one before. Let's save this one too, and we'll see if hopefully one of them will work. Okay, now let's go back to our Photoshop. Okay, here we are. So what we're gonna use is define pattern and our paint bucket tool to put in a pattern that we like. So the first thing we have to do is open up one of those patterns. So I need to go to wherever I saved my textures. Got a bunch of different ones here. I'm just gonna go with the first one and say open. All right, it opened it. Now, so this is a new file, right? Our kitchen is still back here on its other file, and our countertop is right here. So what I need to go is edit, and a little more than halfway down, we have define pattern. I click on that, and it says, do you want me to call it this? Sure, that's fine. Let's just say okay. And now we're done with this file. I can even just close it out. And now I'm going back to my kitchen. And now what I'm gonna do is go to my background layer, and use my magic wand, because we always select things on that background or drawing layer. And I'm gonna click on anything, hold down shift, click on any part of the counter here where I want to apply that marble texture. So now I've chosen all of my countertop. I'm gonna do a new file, I'm sorry, a new layer. I'm gonna click on the word layer one and change it to countertops. And then I'm gonna go to my paint bucket, which is right here. And now I have to change some information. So every time you click on a tool, whatever it is, you'll see that the stuff up here is changing. Those are all your options for the tool. So I'm gonna go to my paint bucket, and up here I change it from foreground to pattern. So what it's saying is I'm gonna fill, not with a color, like we did with our pocheting of the walls, but I'm gonna fill it with a pattern. And then over here, it shows you a picture and a little tiny arrow, which is so important. And the very last thing that you did should be the marble. Then I can just click here. Now I have a beautiful marble countertop, which is hard to see because it's white. So I probably, you know, for the sake of the video, perhaps I should have chosen something else. But that's fine. And actually, I think I see right here a little line. That's what I meant by tiling. It's not repeating in a seamless fashion. It's almost as if it looks like the countertop was done in two pieces or in tiles. But it's okay, I can change it. I mean, I could just redo it and find a different texture, but I can also adjust it. So check this out. I'm gonna go make sure I've got my countertops layer is active, and I go to FX and I go to pattern overlay. It's gonna try and change the pattern on me. No, change it back, the very last one. I can move this around by just clicking with my mouse on that, that top bar there. And I can change the scale right here. And I can find something that looks a little more seamless just by doing that. I think, let's see. That looks good. I'm gonna say okay. Great. All right, let's do it again with our floors. I need my magic wand. Go back to background. I'm just gonna click on my floors. I'm gonna hold down shift and click on that little piece too. Now what I need to do is open up the floor that I want to use. So I go to file, open, remember where I saved my floors. I'm going to use this one because it's got an issue that we have to deal with. So let's open it up. So this one, it's beautiful, but it's got this weird border, right? But we can get rid of it. So let me show you how we do that. I'm just gonna go to my crop tool, which is the one right underneath my magic wand. I'm just gonna grab this and I'm gonna pull it over. So I am cropping out. And just hit enter when you're done. I have now cropped out the part I don't want. So let's do the same thing we did with the marble. Edit, define pattern, and we'll say, this one, can I call it this? And I'll say, okay. And now I can just X out of it. Save changes, no, don't bother. Here we go. We are back to our kitchen floor plan with the floor selected. New layer, let's call it floor. We go to our paint bucket. Again, these are the same steps we just did. So paint bucket, make sure it's on pattern, and now we've got to change it back to the floor that we want. And then we can just click right in the middle of that floor. And that is way too big, right? I mean, that just looks like, that looks like each piece of flooring, like each strip is like a foot or more, actually like a foot and a half, which is way too big for wood flooring. We can change it. Make sure your flooring layer is active. Hit that little FX, pattern overlay. Brings up a dialog box. It's trying to change it to marble on marble, which is a lot of marble. Let's change it back to the flooring that we want. And again, we can play around with the scale and do something that looks, I don't know, just a little better. Maybe that. Yeah, I like that. And that looks good. I'm gonna say, okay. And then I can just do Control D to deselect. And now we are ready to go on to the next step.